Next speaker.
Thank you. I'm Mike Langey. I reside at Mayfair for a creek that was ordered by the 3411 Park. Currently serves president of Mayfair, which includes 142 lead parkway residential addresses. What is now called Park is basically the front yard of Mayfair. We're one of only three buildings that have a lead parkway address, and Mayfair is the only one of these three buildings with residence addresses. Mayfair residents are over 90% with lead parkway addresses and 100% with residential addresses. I've lived in Dallas for 33 years and been a Mayfair resident for the past 12 years. I know most of the residents of Mayfair and live in the crowd of a lot of Dallasites, Texans, and Americans. But since there was the issues that resulted in the council's decision to move the monument, and although we wish there had been more opportunity for dialogue and input for all stakeholders, I moved on and now ready to deal with your deliberations on the street. Simply put, I request the council's consideration to allow lead parkway name to remain. We hope the removal of the monument to be named with the park has sufficiently removed the negative connotation, something associated with these, and the name lead parkway to remain. Others tonight will speak to some of the issues that caused our residents associated with the street name change. Originally, there was consideration for changing several more streets with names tied to federal officers, but the list has been reduced to probably five minor streets, apparently due to the expected cost. Streets like Lynn, Gaston, and Junius were also named after federal officers and are not now being considered for a name change, I understand. In my opinion, the decision to rename these minor streets only places a disproportionate burden on the residents of those streets, in particular the Mayfair. This appears to me to be a token effort to address the issues raised with proper consideration, without proper consideration to the impact. Last evening, I attended Dallas Old Cost Museum event.
Thank you.
Just 5 minutes.
My name's Chris Carr.
Hello, my name is Dee Genova, and I'm a 60-year resident of Mayfair at Turtle Creek at 3411 Lee Parkway. I'm here tonight to challenge the logic being used to make decisions regarding Confederate symbols, most specifically changes to street names. An online Fox 4 News article dated September 22nd reported the task force had identified 17 streets with Confederate ties. Yet the task force recommendation is to change only five because, quote, none of the streets are major thoroughfares, end quote, and, quote, the task force did not recommend changing those major streets, such as Lemon and Gaston, unquote. My research via Google Maps and DCAD reveals that for the five streets identified for change, all appear to be under 5 blocks long and impact approximately 300 residents and businesses. 170 of those appear to be residential, with 140 of those being located in one building, the Fairview Parkway. Dallas has a population of around 1.3 million people and is growing. You may think that changing street names on five streets with less than 200 residents and 100 businesses is not a big ask of those on those five streets. This is where I feel the logic is flawed. Are you making any type of real progress for a more unified society when you make a change that only impacts a small number of the Dallas population? Is there something else the city council could do to educate and unify its citizens? Or is the city simply looking for a headline splash to make it appear you've done something significant when really you haven't done anything significant at all? For many people in the populace, this is going to be a headline, they're going to read it, and they're going to move on with their lives. For those 140 residents in one building and 300 other people impacted, we have to go through a lot of change to change passports, driver's license, bank statements, everything else. I grew up in Michigan. I wasn't strongly educated in Civil War history, and I have no attachment to Confederate tributes. But at the end of the deliberation, with respect to what you do, I hope you can put on a street name change if it does change. Thank you for your time and leadership as mayor and members of the city council. I thank you for listening.
Thank you.
I believe the Mayfair sponsors the Christmas tree.
Yes, I'm very passionate about what I'm going to say. I think it all does pertain to the inhabitants of Canton. My name is Dee Holly, and I also live at the Mayfair in Turtle Creek. The primary information that I feel like you guys have gotten is from Jennifer Scripps and Joyce King, neither are historians, And as a result, it's gotten people all around them. The historical accuracy has been desecrated, and that's a travesty. I've asked this question before. How much money has been spent thus far on the park statue, including cranes, extra security, broken ground in the areas, storage, etc.? As taxpayers, we have the right to know the exact amounts and to view invoices, receipts, IOUs, credit card statements, etc. So I'd like to ask you to all be transparent with that. I've heard a couple of the council members say that the decision on the Lee Park statue has been made and it's done. Well, it can be undone, and it should go back to where it was meant to be. It was not an emergency to remove the statue, and it's not the council's job to govern based on feelings. This decision was hasty, shady, and undermined the majority of the citizens of Dallas. Regarding changing street names, first of all, I attended most of the task force meetings, and I feel like they overstepped their bounds. They were a very biased group, and Ms. Waters refused to listen to any ideas or even facts that did not go along with her agenda. Many of us that live at the only parkway, changing the name of Lee Parkway serves absolutely no purpose other than for the property owners and taxpayers to incur a lot of unnecessary expense and headache changing financial information, passports, banks, driver's license, the list goes on. There's no through traffic on Lee Parkway, no access to and from Lemon Avenue. You actually really have to know where you're going to even find it. And with all that said, I still do thank you guys for listening and having us here to be able to say or to propose our opinions tonight.
Thank you.
Yes. Will be Jim DeVorce, Linda Parcell, Karen Pironi, R.D. Dignan, Robert Jansen, Bill Severa, Sue Ryder, Willie Maddox, Matt Smith, and Jason Cornelius.
Thank you. While everybody's coming down, a couple of things. I do want to, there's many members here of the Cultural Arts Commission, the Public Art Committee, and the Mayor's Task Force. I want to say thank you to them for serving. The other thing I want to say is there was a little bit up here about you know, start to argue or make a comment and shout out what they think about what someone's saying. And we're not going to have that, because if I hear that, we'll have somebody take you out. All right, Jim, you're up. Great to have you.
Thank you. My name is Jim Towards. I live in Mayfair condominiums with my wife, Nico, on 3401 Lee Parkway. First, I just want to thank you for your service to the city. It's a great city. You love it. You're relatively new to downtown. We love it. Thank you to the council as well. Many of you guys have probably moved sometime or another in your life. I've moved a few times as well. It's not a fun process. It's disruptive, burdensome to your life, as you can probably recall. It's not just little things like utility bills, it's bigger things like the IRS that was on an older bill for some reason, right? And Social Security and everything else out there. It just runs the gamut. The key is, though, most moves we make in life are voluntary. You kind of pick and choose what you want there. I just frankly feel like this one's going to be kind of thrust upon us in front of street names changed. Granted, we're going to have a physical move, but we're going to have everything that goes wrong with it. It just doesn't seem right, it doesn't seem fair. Secondly, our street is small. If you've been there, it's tiny actually. 10 feet across from our building, you'll see a sign for our Arlington Hall. The address is 3333 Turquoise Boulevard. I mean, that's literally a 10-foot. It's a confusing place. It's hard to get a taxi. It's hard to get a permit. It's just our building and a couple of businesses. This change is going to make it even worse just to try to operate around our building. And then just finally, if you really believe it's not going to be burdensome to us who live there and things like that, then I think you got to go ahead and change all the streets, right? We actually go to us as well. I saw that in the paper. That one's not going to be changed. It just seems like we can pick on it a little bit. And I just want to really consider the ramifications of the actions you're probably going to take care of. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Linda Parcell, and I live at 341 Lee Parkway. And I have to say that my opinion. lines versus the street name changes are very, very different. I have no problem whatsoever with the removal of the new statute. In fact, honestly, I have to say, I'm glad to see it gone. I think differently about the street name change. I feel that with the street signs and the street names, there's not a shiny bronze or polished marble or glorifying letters describing the individual from which the street is named. I feel that the name has been there for a long, long time, as in many of our streets, and that even if the name has changed, thousands and thousands of our residents are going to continue to refer to it by its old name. I think that the hardships that will be placed on the people who actually live there to change the name creates a lot of bad feeling. And the truth of the matter is, I don't think it really makes a lot of the people who are in favor of the monument being moved feel any better to have a street name changed. I have talked to a few friends that I have who are African American and very much in support of the monument being moved. And I asked for their opinion on how they felt about the street name change because I wanted to know. It affects me personally, but it didn't affect me personally, so I wanted to know what they thought. And I've had the same kind of feedback from them that the name change of the streets is not as important as the monuments, which glorify something that they think feels offensive, matters more. So I would like the committee to really consider the difference between monuments and streets when it comes to their removal. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Bill Zavera. I live at 3401 Lee Parkway in Dallas, unit number 908. Come here tonight actually in hopes of seeing an outbreak of common sense. Changing the name of Lee Parkway has nothing to do with the statue, which is already been removed. It has nothing to do with the memorial. Lee Parkway is not a memorial. It's not a monument. It's a street. It's our street, and it's been our street for 17 years. Lee Parkway is only two blocks long from Lemon Avenue to Hall Street, and one block of that between Lemon and Rollins is taken up by the Mayfair. I want to repeat that. This street is two blocks long. One block is taken up by the Mayfair. There's no through traffic. That one block is our front yard and simply a parking lot. Changing the name of Lee Parkway will not fix potholes. It won't create economic development. It won't improve the quality of life in Dallas. It won't generate more tourism. It won't improve police and fire protection, nor provide more funds for salaries for our police and firemen. Changing the name, though, will, however, cause totally unnecessary expensive work for 143 property owners and their families. The question remains, who benefits? I think it is plain here, nobody benefits. What is the point of all this? Please come down on the side of logic and common sense and vote against this meaningless and unnecessary change in our street name. Do your due diligence and scrub this crazy idea. And if you'd like a free tour of Lee Parkway any day, just call me. I'll give you a free cup of coffee and take you. The only thing that's $10 is definitely it's too short. But at least I'm able to see it for the first time. Thank you very much.
I would really like to not have a
two-block street renamed. It just, for real estate purposes, for individual purposes, it doesn't make sense. However, if the task force and you feel that this is truly going to resolve the issues that we face, I'm going to support it, but I ask that you seek active input from the Mayfair residents and the